You know, when I think about Heritage Day, I start thinking about the conversations that my mom and I would have when I was younger. And some of those conversations were around her life growing up, right? But the one thing that came through from those conversations was the fact that my mom was always future generation conscious, right? She always thought about how the life that she wanted to build for her future kids, right? She told me that, you know, throughout her struggles, the one thing that kept her going was to say, I don't want my kids to live the kind of life that I've lived. You know, she struggled when she was younger. She had challenges because her parents died when she was still very young. When she was a toddler, she didn't have parents. So she was raised by relatives, and people can do the best that they can do. But I suppose at the back of her mind, she always thought, but how would have life been had my parents lived to raise me, right? So she had a whole lot of struggles, right? But she was always conscious about the kind of life that she wanted to carve for her future kids. So that gave me a consciousness for future generations. I've always grown up to think about the legacy that I want to leave for my kids as well. I want my kids to live a better life than, you know, the way I was raised. I always said to myself, I didn't know how that would look like. At the time, I thought maybe we'd have more money because we had struggles with money at my house, right? My mom was a primary school teacher, my dad was a taxi driver, so we didn't have a lot of money. So I thought improving the kind of life that we had would be to have loads of money, and that's why I just wanted to be an accountant, just to grab money from all directions, right? But you know, little did I know that God had different plans for me, and that's what I want to talk to you about today. You know, what is your heritage? So in 2018, I handed in my resignation later, you know, at work, because I had a calling on my life, and for once I knew exactly what I wanted to do. What God was saying was my purpose, right? And at the time, before handing in my resignation, I had serious conversations with myself because I was struggling between what I know is the best life of, you know, studying, getting a good job in a big corporate company and staying there until retirement time. That was the best life that I knew. But God was calling me into something that I had never seen before in my family. You know, a life outside of corporate. And that was success for, that is success for my family, right? You know, so a life outside of corporate is just a life unknown for me. But you know, as I was thinking about my descendants, future children, I started thinking, but what legacy would I be leaving for them if I don't take a courageous move right now? If I don't be bold enough to act on what God is calling me to, right? So I made the decision because I was thinking about something beyond myself. I decided to live a life that was not just dedicated to me enjoying a good life right now, but a life that was dedicated to carving a certain route for my children. And heritage right now to me means a legacy, right? And the first thing that I think about when I think about legacy, I start thinking the word freedom. And you know, when I made that decision, I was basically buying generational freedom for my descendants. Freedom to be who God says they are, no matter what society says. I mean, it was unheard of when I left my job to start all over again, or to start from the beginning, right? Starting a new career at the age of 35, what are you saying? I mean, people around me were confused. They just didn't get what I was trying to do. But because I have always been future generation conscious, and the legacy to me that I wanted to leave was more important than the gains of now, that has kept me going up until now. You know, even when I had to change my lifestyle, I mean, we were that couple that used to go away all the time, right? We just loved going out with my husband. But when I sacrificed my salary, then it was one of those things that we had to minimize on the travels. But hey, you know what? God is always on my side. COVID happened. We couldn't travel anyway, right? Not that COVID was a good thing, but I'm saying, you know, I was talking about finding a sweet spot of peace in a challenging situations. And that's what I found out. You know, when I quit my job, I was supposed to have eased up on the traveling, but actually COVID made all of us ease up on traveling, right? So it worked out in the end. So having that consciousness to do things right now that would benefit my children and their children has always been something that has made me give my life away as a sacrificial lamb. And you know, I was doing all of this for my future generation, but I started realizing that by me changing me right now in order to benefit future generations, I'm actually impacting even the people who are connected to me at this moment. And it was something I didn't even think about, right? So my heritage right now is not only going to benefit the future children that I'm going to have, but it's already benefiting those who are connected to me at this moment. So I just wanted to find out, how do you define heritage? Is it about the things that you saw your family doing growing up and now you have introduced into your family and you're hoping your children will take them on into their life in the future? What does heritage mean to you and how does that look like for you? You know, I've always said, before you go out there to find people's opinions, you need to sit down with yourself on any concept and define it for yourself. What does it mean to you, right? Because only you know what your soul needs, right? And you know, we can come up with all sorts of definitions and try and influence you. They will make you feel uncomfortable until you decide what this day means to you. So before you go out there to celebrate with your family and have fun with your friends, please take a moment to yourself and reflect on this day. What does it mean to you, so that when you go out there to find other people's opinions, at least you will have the foundation of what it means to you as an individual. Happy Heritage Day, South Africa. I hope you enjoy your day the best way you know how, the best way you have defined it for yourself. For me, heritage means legacy, and legacy means freedom. I am Pulemons, your inner peace and purpose coach.